afternoon. Good afternoon, goedemiddag, Mweni. I'm Director Roberts. Can I take this thing off? It's really, I think my voice carry well enough. I'm Director Roberts. I'm. Really?
Yeah. Yeah, we can do that.
Too. Better? Can you hear me?
Sound check, you got it? Live stream.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Got it. Right. He's checking the sound quickly. Speak now, Robbie.
All right, can you hear me?
Yeah.
That's fine. All right, maybe just a bit of history, and just before I starting, I just want to indicate to all of you that if you dare ask me any questions today, I'm from law enforcement, metro police and traffic within the city of Cape Town. So there's somebody outside taking down all your registration numbers, for starters. And I would like to identify you with your registration number just to check up all your outstanding warrants and outstanding fines. And I've got the people on standby to take you away to Milton SAP. So to start off, I was requested to speak about the city of Cape Town, and specifically with regarding to policing in the city of Cape Town. And to be honest with you, we are busy taking over the South African police services in the Western Cape. And I am saying that in a very light note, but if you're looking what the city is actually doing for the community out there, and the people are not always aware what is safety and security in the city of Cape Town, how it look like, and what are we doing out there. And I think after my presentation today, you will have a better understanding with all our functions, all our capabilities within the city of Cape Town, and how you can use us in order to assist you in terms of fighting crime within the city and the boundaries of the metropole. So we are responsible for the whole metropole, up from Gordon's Bay to Atlantis, from Atlantis to Vishoek, and all the way back to Gordon's Bay. And that's our area of responsibility. We are divided into four areas that we call the area east, north, south, and west, central, as it's been called now. So we're operating in all four areas. Maybe just to get to the structure, accountable to our mayor, executive mayor, Honorable Dan Plato, and then we've got the city manager, and then it starts off with our executive director for safety and security, who's Richard Bosman, and then on the left-hand side, you will see I'm the director for operational coordination, and I'm responsible for law enforcement, traffic enforcement, and then also for the special investigation unit and the VIP unit. And then as my role for operational coordination, I've got the direct link also with the Metro Police. And then the other departments within safety and security. On the safety side, we've got the fire emergency services, disaster risk management, as well as the 107 call center, and all the events that's been coordinated. So if you've got an animal event and it's big as this one, then you need actually a safety and security operational plan to deal with that. You can just continue with that one. That's just a breakdown with regarding to our services. Next one, continue. Next one, that's our area east, the Khayelitsha, Gordon's Bay, Somerset West area, that's our area east. Area north is the Atlantis, Belleville, Milton area. Then we've got area south with regarding to Nyanga, Guguletu, Manenberg, and those areas. And then area west, from Cape Town all the way to Simonstown and back to Lansdowne. So that's our operating area within the safety and security environment. Next one. If you're looking at the values of the Directorate for Safety and Security, we are the Opportunity City, the Safe City, the Caring City, and the Inclusive City, as well as the Well-Run City. And to be fair and square with you, I think we've got the best run municipality with regarding to the metropoles within the country at the moment, and in terms of our safety and security as well. We protect everyone's rights and be impartial, respectful, and open and accountable to the community out there. Use the powers to, that's been given to us in a responsible way, and if we are not adhering to that, you've got the right to report us and to deal with us in that way. We evaluate our services continuously and make every effort to improve on it on a daily basis. And we ensure effective, efficient, and economic use of our resources. And if there's anybody that know or that's aware of the misuse of any of our resources, specifically our vehicles, I'm on about 200 WhatsApp groups. And another one from the Animal Society can just add to that as well, and that is actually how we communicate with each other. And then we cooperate with all the communities and all spheres of government and other relevant role players. And then we ensure a sound and operational partnership with all relevant role players inside the city, as well as with our external role players and the community. Just with regarding to our focus area, the strategic focus area for the financial year, we are back to basics. And we are focusing on discipline, dress code, individual productivity of members, well-motivated, positive attitude, efficiency, and effectiveness. And I can tell you I'm not going through that whole slide, but accountability at the end of the day ensures discipline. And if you don't keep your people accounted, and specifically on the most senior level, that is where you need to have your managers, your chiefs, your officers with the rank, to keep them accountable to you in terms of the service out there that they have to render. And we focus on leadership and leadership training within the environment of safety and security, and as well as the responsibility towards our community. I will also indicate to you with regarding to our roles, how we are monitoring all the services within the city of Cape Town and in terms of command and control out there. Our chiefs have to account in traffic, law enforcement, as well as the Metro Police and the Special Investigation Unit have to account on a weekly basis with regarding to their performance, with regarding to all the service requests that they are dealing with, and to make sure that the level of accountability is the highest up there. With regarding to our Area 2 service delivery, we are focusing on the broken window syndrome, and it's to take care of the petty and the small things that leads to bigger crime and bigger issues at the end of the day. And that is why we enforce the bylaws within the city of Cape Town, because it's those small things that are really lead up to bigger crime issues at the end of the day. And I can indicate to you one of the questions that the one will be with regarding to the displaced people or the street people. I don't like the word street people. I rather call them displaced people. And there was big issues in the media with regarding to the city finding homeless people, finding street people. And I'm standing here today with you and indicate to you that it is still an issue. But I'm not finding a person because he's homeless or he's a street person. I'm finding him because of the bylaw contravention, by making a fire, put up a structure. And that is the reasons of the fines, and not by finding him due to the fact that he's a homeless person. That is where social development and the city of Cape Town, we can reintegrate them with their families and get them to shelters as the safe space in the city of Cape Town. So we ensure the enforcement of the city bylaws, the effectiveness in terms of the enforcement with regarding to the Road Traffic Act, as well as crime prevention within the city of Cape Town. Next slide. If you're looking at focus area four, our focus area, our operational approach is with regarding to sharing of information in terms of our strategic information intelligence management system. And I'm a previous member of the South African police. I left the police as a major general in the police. And for the 32 years, I was dealing with all the crime statistics within the city of Cape Town on a daily basis and planned and deal with issues. And as a colleague that was part of the South African police in the audience knows that we are not allowed to share statistics with you. But to be honest with you, if you cannot plan and you cannot deploy your services if you are not aware of the crime situation within specific areas. If I'm not aware of the total of murders or the attempted murders or robberies or assaults that's taking place in Milnerton, then I cannot actually support the South African police services in getting the service out there with regarding to that hotspot areas and areas of deployment. And that is why it's so important to share information with each other. And social media is actually one of the greatest mechanisms that we are using today to determine what is going on in an area. Because the other night I went to a workshop in the city of Cape Town in terms of the Cape Town SIDS, the City Improvement District. And then and the presentation was made about 350 incidents within the CBD in a period of a month's time. But when you're looking at the crime, there were only about 54 cases reported. And the 54 cases will not give you a clear indication where crime is happening. But when you do an analysis with regarding to all the incidents where it happened, it gives you a better understanding where's your hotspots, where do you need to focus, what do you need to do and to plan with regarding to the crime in those specific area. And that is why the city is currently busy with incident reporting and to see how we can deal with it. I'm also part of the Premier's group that meet every second Wednesday in terms of a specific area within in the metropole. And the reason for that is that the national operation with Operation Lockdown, which the South African Defence Force are currently assisting, is focusing on 15 identified areas. Now this area in Hanover Park is a focus area that don't receive any additional resources at the moment. And it is one of the hotspot areas within that specific gang environment. And the statistics in terms of murders and attempted murders is now provided by the health department, because every single person that's been murdered have to go to a morgue, a mortuary. So instead of the police providing the statistics to your community and indicating to you and making you aware of what is going on a daily basis, a weekly basis, and a monthly basis in your area, you would be much aware of your own safety and security. And you would put measures in place to secure yourself, specifically if you know that you are living in a hotspot area and that you need to be aware of this. And that is really where the city of Cape Town are going to ensure or to try to make sure that the South African police don't make the stats available once a year. But to get the statistics available to the community on a daily and a weekly and a monthly basis. The next focus area is with regarding to our approach in terms of our operations. And we've got intelligence operations. Thanks a lot. That will be welcome. And I'm straightforward. Sorry, just a moment. Double brandy, please. The current focus areas within the city of Cape Town, and by means of joint operations, integrated operations, or autonomous operation, we are focusing on different threads. And our focuses from the city side is an integrated focus with the gang violence. Currently, we've got 27 gang-invested identified hotspot areas within the metropole. 27 areas, and it's actually frightening to know that with the police areas within the city of Cape Town, we've got a total of 60. And 27, nearly 50% of all the policing areas within the city, the metropole area, has been identified as gang-invested high priority areas in the city. So there's a lot of focus from our side on gang violence as well, and to support the South African police in terms of that. Then the integrated focus on transport-related threats, and I attended yesterday the monthly priority meeting on transport. We focus on taxis. No questions from any in terms of any taxis today, please. I've got your number plate. Taxis, the bus services. There's a lot of robberies on the My City and the Golden Arrow buses. Of having a team of law enforcement officers deployed now on the buses. Previously, there were no people on the bus, or no incidents on the buses, and now you need to create a unit actually to deploy it on the Golden Arrow buses to ensure that the passengers are safe and that you prevent the robbery cases and even the rape cases on the buses with regarding to that. Then you've got the trains. I don't want to go to Plaza and all the issues with the train burnings. We created a unit of 100 members from the city of Cape Town as the railway enforcement unit. And since June, we are waiting for the Plaza and the province to renew the budget in terms of the financial year. But there was a down scaling of reporting of incidents on the trains since our deployment of our members on the trains. So in the transport environment, we are doing a lot from the city of Cape Town. Then I've got the integrated approach with regarding to protest actions and service delivery. Those who are using the N2 and the R300, no questions. Those who are coming from Somerset West and the Luandle area, no questions, please. You know exactly what is going on a daily basis with the highways and byways. And with regarding to shutdown and gatfall and every movement that you are getting in order to police. And that's our focus areas. We are, when there's protests in these areas, you have to withdraw all your members from the different areas in order to fight crime. And that is the problem, because you cannot sustain your deployment in those areas due to the threat and due to a shortage of nearly 3,000 members within the South African police services within the Western Cape. And you need to play to replace that multi-force supplier all the time with regarding to these threats. Then we've got the threat of land invasions within the city of Cape Town. And it is not only city land. It is not only city land. We've got private land invasions. We've got city land invasions. We've got national land, provincial land. And most problematic is that the PIE Act kicks in. You know, if your land is invaded tomorrow, if there's a part of your area that's invaded and it's on city land, if you don't act immediately in terms of that particular land, when the structure has been set up and they do it, they bring the stove and they bring the bed and they bring the cupboards, and tomorrow they just put up the structure, and within an hour it looks if that person was staying there for a period of time. And then you need to apply for an interdict or a court order to get him off the land and to evict him. And you must first get emergency housing in place as well. So the land invasions are really problematic with regarding to that. But we've got a land invasion unit that supports the South African police and the housing unit within the city of Cape Town to deal with it. Then we've got the CCTV surveillance within the city of Cape Town. Best in the country, and I would like to invite you to if you're in the vicinity of Goodwood at the TMC, just behind the fire station, my office is there. We've got the best integrated operational room within the country. The police are busy having the blueprint for the rest of the country in terms of our integrated approach. We've got the provincial traffic there. We've got the Cape Town traffic there. We've got the Metro Police there. We've got the law enforcement there. We've got the South African Police Services currently deploying there. We've got the Department of Education deployed in the most problematic schools, where all our school resource officer unit are deployed in. Within that unit, we've got the medical emergency services out there. We've got all the neighborhood watchers in that particular area, and there's space for the animal welfare in order to coordinate that as well. If I can bring all the role players together in fighting crime in an integrated way. You cannot fight crime in silos. The police cannot be the sole responsible organization to fight crime. And then you've got safety and security. I'm in the process of linking up all the private security operational rooms to the TMC at our operational center so that there's communication between the 10 most prevalent private security organizations within the city or the metropole in order to link that coordination together. If you're going to other call centers, you don't find it. We are busy trying to get all the LPR user cameras from the public linked up to the TMC. And I can take you through that centers. We are monitoring the highways and the byways. We are monitoring over 800 cameras. We've got a detection of crime incidents between 80 and 150 per week on the cameras. We've got reaction units from the city of Cape Town with the South African Police Services to react on those incidents. The smash and grabs on the N2 and all over, we are focusing on those areas. We sent out from the city of Cape Town a letter to the provincial commissioner to identify all the hotspots in the 60 station areas where they want to deploy or redeploy or want the location of a camera within their community in order to coordinate and to monitor and to start addressing crime in terms of technology. Because the end of the day, you are not having the resources to be everywhere, but if you use technology in order to fight crime, it's much more better and coordinated. Then crimes against women and children, it's one of our priorities. Then our integrated operations, as I mentioned, and also the analysis of crime in terms of our dashboard, and also real-time attendance. If you phone 107, and I want you to really test our service, and you can take the following numbers down, please. 107, or you can phone 021-480-7700. Take that now down, and you can take down my cell phone number as well. 079-5522-1701, 079-522-1701. And you can test me. You can really test me. If you are not happy with any service within the policing environment of the city of Cape Town, they need to give you a reference number. They need to address your complaint. If it's a bylaw enforcement or it's a crime prevention issue, or it's a traffic-related issue, they need to give you a reference number And by giving you that reference number, if you are not happy with the service that was rendered or they did not come back to you with regarding to that service, you just phone me and you give me this reference number and I will follow it up and I will come back to you with regarding to the service in terms of the city. Next one, just to indicate to you, Metro Police, the total of officers that we've got currently out of nearly 700, of which 483 members are in the support environment, with 268 in the, out of the 483, 268 are in the operational environment. Traffic, out of the 1,150 officers within the city of Cape Town, we've got 495 operational officers out there. And then within law enforcement, out of the 941 officers, we've got 661 permanent members, 281 on contract, and then we've got 472 volunteers. And if you want to join the city as a volunteer, please feel free to contact me and we can make you part of our environment. The total of vehicles that's been part of that in Metro Police, 438, traffic 430, and law enforcement 484. Next one, I just want to indicate to you with regarding to operational coordination. I know I'm running out of time, but the next slide, please. Next one. Those are the threats that we are currently responsible and focusing in terms of the city of Cape Town. We've got crime in general, then we've got the gang-related threats, our transport-related threats, I mentioned it to you, our marine environment with regarding to poaching. I was part and parcel of a meeting this week to focus in terms of our marine environment, and that is from Silverstrom all around to Gordons Bay, that there's a lot of poaching happening along our and fishing, illegal fishing, happening on a daily basis. And we've got a marine unit that is currently focusing on that. Then the other threat is protest actions and service delivery related threats. Then the school related threats within the city of Cape Town. The city of Cape Town safety and security are deploying at 53 schools two law enforcement officers on a daily basis. Just to make sure that the children in that environment is safe and secure, and to act on any incidents within the city of Cape Town. And if you try to take that school resource officer away, you've got the principal on your back. He want to sue you. And the urge for having more school resource officers at the different schools are really one of the big issues within the city of Cape Town. And we are deploying them on a daily basis from 8 o'clock till 3 o'clock in the afternoon. And then they form part of after hours recreation and sport programs. And we are assisting our children out there. Then we've got also the by-law contraventions with regarding to road safety, housing and land invasion issues, firearms. And as it was indicated yesterday on social media and this morning, over 500 firearms that were got lost within the South African police services. And it's not only in the police services, but it's firearms that are available out there to commit murders, to commit attempted murders, to be involved in gang violence, and with regarding to robberies. Then the big problem, drugs, within our schools, in our areas, and by legalizing it, it's getting a big problem at the end of the day as well. We've got a liquor enforcement unit that focus directly on the Shabins, and then corruption. And I can tell you, within the safety and security environment and within the city of Cape Town, we are locking up our own officials in terms of corruption. And we've got an oversight body. And it's not happening in the city or in any other city within terms of oversight. We've got a civilian oversight that meets on a monthly basis with the safety and security policing environment of the city to make sure that we are doing our job, to make sure that we are rendering the service that we that's responsible, and that it's a committee existing out of your people sitting here, out of the public. So that we need to go and account to them, and they've got our reports prior to this meeting, and they asking questions, why is this not happening? And then the rest of the public are also giving them information where the people are not happy with the service of the city. So those are our threats. Our partnerships, I'm not going into that. It is with all the departments in the city, and then also with external partners that we are planning and sitting together in order to deal with the issues out there. That's all our priority committees with regarding to all the threats, and I'm representing the city on all these priority committees. And be aware that all these priority committees needs to once a month account to the provincial joints that's been chaired by the provincial commissioner and the SANDF. Then we've got our management forums. There's the civic forum, the civilian oversight forum, and those are the forums that manage our areas. I spoke about joint and integrated and autonomous operations with all our role players, and I'm just running through that. You can just continue. We are currently using, you're a bit slow, you must check your, the next one. You must check me if I we are currently, we've got a system in the police, in safety and security within the city of Cape Town. Every single complaint that's been reported to 107 or to 480-77-7700 gets dispatched to a member's cell phone. So we are receiving all the complaints on the cell phone and wherever you patrol, and you need to, when I'm getting to your place and you were the complainant regarding, and I believe that there's no complaints with dog barking here because you are protecting the animals. So no bylaw complaints in terms of animals today. But I received this call, I'm taking a video, I'm taking the image, and I'm loading up it up on our system in order whenever I have to go to court, that evidence is available immediately. It's a new system, it's call taking, call dispatching, mobile field enablement, case management, workforce management, and reporting. And if you report or phone or reported an incident to the Safety and Security Directorate and you are not happy, I can, this device being tracked every day, I can see where this vehicle went in terms of that. I'm monitoring every single vehicle within the city of Cape Town on a constant basis, 24 hours. So I can track your complaint, I can track that vehicle who attended to you, and I can see why did it take him 3 hours to get to you, with how many complaints he were busy with, and why did it take so long to attend to your complaint. So that is our system that we are currently using. We are really the front runners in technology within the country in terms of all the municipalities. The next one. Just going to indicate to you quickly, and I'm going to run through this. It's just a mandate with law enforcement. Next one. In each of the areas, I've got base stations where law enforcement are deployed, and those are the area law enforcement units that needs to attend to your complaint. The next one. Those are all the units within the city. And you can see we are busy taking over the policing environment within the city. I've got a liquor unit, a vice unit. If you've got problems in terms of prostitution or liquor, or the cable theft, we've got a metal theft unit, we've got a stabilization unit that is currently deployed in the Hanover Park area, our school resource officers unit, the social housing unit, all those that are using our rental stock units within the city, and that is using or giving us problems. Drug users, criminals, we are evicting them out of that housing unit, and the social housing unit will take the responsibility there. Problem buildings in your area, standing empty, problematic in your area. We've got a unit that's dealing with all those empty houses or buildings or business areas that are really a problem for us in the city, because that's where you are actually getting your homeless peoples or your criminals or your drug dealings. That's where your children from your schools are gathering and getting their drugs at these problem buildings. And mine, including mine, I've got also children. So then it's our land invasion unit, the informal trading unit, the displaced people's unit, the rapid response unit in order to attend to all your crime, the marine unit, the animal unit. I've got an animal unit as well. And the animal unit are really to support you. And I requested one of my animal unit members to be here if there's any complaints from your side. But I will make my email available to you that if you've got really a problem relating to animals, please forward that specific service request or mail to me directly so that I can attend to that and I can support you and help you in order to do. Or if you are aware of people misusing animals in this area and you want to report it, I've got an animal unit within each area in the city of Cape Town, and they will attend to your complaint and assist you and help you. And then we've got the courts unit, the lost and stolen theft unit, and then the railway enforcement unit. We are even currently, the next slide, establishing a rural safety unit for the farms within the city. The bus enforcement unit I mentioned to you, and currently we've got also a facility protection unit rolling out to all the services. I'm running out of time. I'm just going through to the Metro Police. The same situation regarding to the Metro base stations in all the areas. I will make this presentation available to you. And those are the units within Metro Police. Next one. Those are the Metro. I've got a dark unit, a mountain unit with horses, the tactical response unit, the gang unit, the neighborhood safety officers operating in the various areas, the CCTV mobile unit, the Cyclops, internal affairs, information management, and we've got also the police academy responsible for training. Then we've got the traffic services, and you are going to be very careful here. They are based in all the areas, with regarding to the normal traffic areas, and then with regarding to the special units within the areas, I've got a transport enforcement unit that focus on taxis. But you know, to address over 7,000 taxis just in the metropole with 14 members, it's problematic. But we are currently using all our resources in order to address the taxi problems within the city of Cape Town. And to send me a photo of a taxi that is in a bus lane or driving on the yellow lane, I cannot do anything about it, because you as a person need to go to the police to register a reckless and negligent driving case there, because the national prosecuting authorities don't prosecute any person in terms of video footage or if there's no complainant. And we are in the process from the city of Cape Town that we will be, if we pick this up on the cameras, to be the complainant in that case and to take this evidence as a complainant to the national prosecuting authorities in order to see if they can prosecute. Then we've got the ghost squad, those that are driving behind you in unmarked vehicles, and while you're on the cell phone, stop you from behind and say, "Somebody, just see the blue light." People, the community out there hate them. But that, you know how many accidents you prevent by addressing these people that speaking on cell phones. And I don't know, they're sitting like this. Instead of like sitting like this, they are talking like this. I don't know if they think maybe the traffic cop will not arrest him now because, or give him the phone, but that is the problem. Just go back quickly, one slide, just back, I'm nearly finished. Our reclaim unit, our school education unit, we are giving education in terms of traffic safety, traffic enforcement at the schools, and then we've got our TMC control room and our fraudulent investigation. And my last slide is our special investigation unit. It is where we support the South African police in investigating crime cases where we know that our members are involved in, and by meaning drug-related cases, firearm-related cases, where we are responsible for executing those arrests. And we've got a watching brief on those cases to make sure that those cases ended up at the courts. Because there's a lot of these cases that's been reported that don't end up at court. And that's why we've got a special investigation unit in order to deal with the watching brief. They are also the people. That's the indication I need to stop. This unit is also responsible for our internal investigation with regarding to any arrest, corruption whatsoever. They assist with shadow investigation, fraud and corruption, and those are the cases. That is the safety and security, and I can really keep you busy for the whole day. But as I indicated when I started off, we are busy taking over the policing environment in the city of Cape Town. And the idea is not to take over the police services. The idea is to support the police due to the shortage of manpower or personnel within the Western Cape and within the metropole. And we want to ensure a better service to all the public out there. If you've got a problem, please, you've got my number. I want to give you my email. It's an easy email. It is pietrus.roberts. Pietrus, P-E-T-R-U-S, dot Roberts, with a double B, R-O-B-B-E-R-T-S, at capetown.gov.za. Feel free to make contact with me. Feel free to set up a meeting with me. If there's a problem in your environment with animals, or the misuse of animals, or bullfights, these dog fights, or anything, and you are aware of it, I've got a special animal unit that investigate those cases. And if you need to organize the public order police from the South African Police Services to address those issues, then we need to do it. But that is one of the big problems currently, in specifically in the gang-invested areas, where this bullfights or dogfights, whatever you want to call it, is really a disturbing issue in that environment. Please call upon me. Phone me or WhatsApp me. I'm on your WhatsApp group now, so you're more than welcome to deal with me. Any questions? Four? So what I really want to do, and there's a record that is available with regarding to your information out there, and hopefully all your information is available. But 107, or that number that you indicated to that I gave to the... Just take this over here. The number that I gave to you, 407700, and then you indicate that it's an animal-related complaint or a service request, and you want the animal unit to deal with this issue. Or you can phone 10111 as well, but due to the fact that I've got an animal unit, you can phone me directly and indicate to the call taker up there that this is an animal-related issue that should be reported to law enforcement within the city of Cape Town. Any other questions?
Sorry, I come from both sides, so we obviously call out of your jurisdiction, but we have an
There's a law enforcement component within the overburden.
Because our issue at this point is that it seems like the law enforcement isn't actually using the bylaws. They're more abiding by what the community says.
Well, it's a problem. It's problem. Out of the boundaries, but what you can do, there's a law enforcement in the overburden. And you can mail me your concerns. I can forward that mail, or you can just request me, give me the information of the law enforcement in the Overberg area, and I will provide it to you. And I know the commander very well, and he will attend to your issues. And if you've got a problem, call me directly.
Okay, thank you.
Any other questions? Last one, last round. Is a problematic area within that Helderberg Basin. Luandle is currently a problematic area, specifically on the N2 in that specific area. Someone should please that whole stretch from Gordon Bay, I would say to Makassar, that whole area. But Makassar is a problematic area at the moment. Kailitsa, it's problematic as well. It's one of the areas. And I can indicate to you the 15 lockdown areas that are the South African Police and the National Defence Force currently focusing is the Kailitsa area, the Luand, the Mufuleni area, it's the Nyanga area, and the Philippi East area. Those are the four areas within your African Township area. And then you've got your Manenberg, your Mitchell's Plain, your Bishop Lagos area, your Delft area, your Kraaifontein area. It's also a problematic area. And then there's the Elsizora area. Those are the 10 most problematic areas identified. But gang areas problematic. I can start off Ocean View is a problematic area. You've got Steenberg, that is a problematic area. You've got the Grassy Park as one of the gang areas. You've got Hanover Park in the Philippi area, Manenberg, Bishop Lagos, Elsies River, Delft, Ravensmead, Kraaifontein, Kalksteenfontein, Atlantis, and that is the 27 areas regarding to that. If you I always tell the public out there is those areas are the real problematic ones, but you've got the N2 and the R3 that is really problematic. It's not the same as the N1. The N1 is fine, but the N2 and the R3 is one of our problematic roads. Stellenbosch material is one of our problematic roads. The N7. The Noon, this area, it's a problematic road. The M3 and the M5 is fine. It is not that problematic at the moment.
Thanks, Robbie. Thank you, Robbie.